to a certain result. Eventually, you get to a point where the efforting, you see, no longer serves you. You arrive at a point where there's only so much that you can muster up in terms of effort because you realize that nothing matters. You might even feel a little sad, maybe a little depressed from time to time. But then, that's when the grace occurs. That's when the heart current, when it seems as though where God, if you will, reaches in and recognizes the humility. You may stay in that state for a while, and then it, you can feel it pulling you in. Whatever it is, it's not a thing, but you feel the gratitude, and the love of God, whatever, of everything, of everyone. You feel that you are now beneath the layer of the ocean. You're beneath the surface. You see, it's like you're in the depths, and everything is now seen as an emanation of you, felt as an emanation of I. And that's ultimately where it leads. So, just recognize that this world is just a big bag of thoughts. That's all it is, and you're looking through it. You're looking through this filter that's making it appear solid. And so, it's reversing the flow of that. And whatever it is that you're going through, it's perfect right now. When you have, if you have the intention for the mind to become still, it will. Your intention, you see, intention is important because intention drives manifestation above all else. See, even above desire, though they are somewhat connected, but intention is powerful, you see, because your desires will be reflected through your intention. They will proliferate off of that. But if your intention is, let's just say, to become a millionaire, then your bag is going to start to fill with thoughts of how to be a millionaire. Your bag is not going to be empty. It's going to be filling, because you're filling your mind. When you surrender, you see the bag empties. If you want to become, let's just say, a world-class gymnast, or a football player in the NFL, or whatever someone wants to be, again, the swelling, the growing of the me, wanting to become someone special. The surrender now, the devotion, is no longer to that inner dimension of stillness. It's now to things. The way people are going to look at me, the respect, the things, and now most people don't want to hear this. So, to the ego, this is like talking about suicide. But as you begin to turn your mind inward, those thoughts begin to pull apart. In a sense, you're in a struggle. There's a certain battle going on, represented in the Bible. Satan, you see, when Jesus encounters Satan in the desert, and there's this going back and forth where he's being tempted by the devil, so to speak, and this is the mind tempting you with your greatest desires, that or the kingdom of heaven. And so, of course, if you pick the world, you're going to suffer. This is what I'm talking about. But if you choose the kingdom of heaven, if you choose God, I'm not talking about the anthropomorphic aspect of God. I'm talking about that inner joyous realm within yourself, that once you have a glimpse of that, nothing can compare. Once you have one glimpse of it, nothing can win out over that, because you'll always remember it. You'll always know. You may forget from time to time, but it will be in there underneath it all. And the pull outward will not be as strong anymore. You say, why is it that 10 years ago I was able to work so many hours and work so hard in order to achieve these things, and today I just don't have that kind of gumption to get out and do that, because you realize that there's no lasting happiness in those things. Surrender and know that you will always be taken care of. Develop the trust through understanding. As the mind begins to empty, the presence begins to make itself more prevalent in your awareness, and you become more aware of things as they happen. And as you become more aware, you see the inner workings of how God is bringing you to this state of inner joy, and has been all along. Even with you kicking and screaming, the love of God still is able to do that without even skipping a beat. You begin to see that things happen more easily when you're not trying. The harder you try, or in a great way, so San says, the faster you walk, the slower you move. The harder you try, right, the more you strain, the more problems you have. So the key is to relax into each situation and remain aware. And that is the key. Simplify your life as much as you can. Slow down. Look and see where you're going and what you're trying to achieve. And then as everything begins to turn inward, you become more sensitive and you say, hey, either this feels like this is where, you know, your service is, or it doesn't. If it's not, then you just reassess the direction that you're going. Okay. And this is the benefit of allowing the mind to turn inward, because when the mind is going outward, you don't know where you're going. Of course, you're not really doing it anyway. The appearance is that I'm doing it, because as long as that knot is tight and the bag is filling, there is the feeling of me. That knot, that clamp that opens and closes the bag, so to speak, is felt as a knot within the body. That's the feeling of me, the ego. It's not really a thing, it doesn't really exist, but it's felt that way when the mind is externalizing. See, or when the body is holding thoughts or tensions in it, ignorance. As soon as it begins to empty, the knot relaxes and the me is not so dense. Okay. You think of it in this way, it's very easy to pretty much monitor what's occurring in your life. Whenever you feel uncomfortable, you know you're in the mind. You know your bag is full or filling. Right? when you wake up in the morning, first thing, see the knot's hardly there, you barely even feel the knot. First thing, in fact, you see the mind hasn't really emerged yet. Still starting to extend its tentacles into the world of forms. Now if you initially, when you're learning to meditate, if you initially get up, as soon as you wake up, rather than laying there and letting the mind proliferate, get up immediately, meditate, and then bring that relaxed alertness into the day. And operate and function from there. Eat with mindfulness, eat with awareness and sensitivity. Drive to work, or if you're at home, work with sensitivity. Make everything a meditation in the now, which is just being very still and feeling I. And you will not recognize the work. Things that you've had difficulty doing for long periods of time will become effortless. And it's essentially giving attention to the eyes, like surrendering everything to God and letting God do it, letting the entire existence do it, instead of your little bag. So. Trying to grow their bags. The more people are trying to grow their bags, you see, then the vibration begins to make your bag want to grow. The more you hang around with bags that are
it's baggage.
Turning inward, yeah. Exactly. You turn in, and suddenly you begin to notice that the people who are around you, their bags are also turning in. See, they're also turning in. Their attention, they're feeling the eye. That doesn't necessarily mean they're always going to be nice. It means they may be going through a process of surrendering, so they may not always be nice. Spiritual, true spiritual devotees, devotees of the truth, are not always fun to be around. There can be great anguish prior to the surrender, the full and utter surrender. So you may say, well, when I first started meditating, my mind was really still. I really enjoyed it. And then years later, I'm this irritable, you know, angry old person. And that's just because as the bag begins to empty, you see all this past conditioning gets churned up. And so it can get a little intense at times. But you always return to the eye. Because no matter how intense things are, when you ask yourself, who's aware of this? I am. You're behind the mind. You move behind the mind so it doesn't really matter what's going on in the mind. It's only when we forget, you see, that we get caught up in the drama of thoughts, actions, fear, resentment, lust, ambition, greed. As soon as we say, who's aware of those things? Because it's not you. You know. No matter what behavior the body seems to be demonstrating, or no matter what kind of thoughts come up in your mind, from time to time, we may get a little disgusted with our own thoughts and say, oh, I can't believe I had that thought. Well, that's despicable. And you can get angry at yourself and start judging yourself for these thoughts. That's just nonsense. That's just another trick of the mind. You say, oh, who's aware of that thought? I am. As soon as you say that, you're behind the mind again, and it can't possibly.